My name is Dr Rita Scully, and I'm a lecturer at Limerick Institute of Technology in Ireland. Today, we're going to take a look at one of the rules in differentiation. We're going to look at the chain rule. This video will include where we use the chain rule, what the chain rule is, and two examples of how we apply the chain rule in differentiation. Today we're looking at differentiation, the chain rule, and how it's used in differentiation. The chain rule is used when we need to differentiate a function of a function. One example of this is cos x to the power of 3. This is different from the standard cos x. So here we basically have two functions, f of x and g of x. So when y is equal to f of g of x, then for our example, f of x is equal to cos x and g of x is equal to x cubed. So from that, we can see that f of g of x equals f of x cubed, which equals cos of x cubed. So let's work through the steps we would use to differentiate a function of a function. If we want to find y equal to f of g of x or dy dx, then there's two steps that we need to follow when we use the chain rule. One, we substitute u for g of x, so y equals f of u, and then we apply the chain rule. The chain rule states that dy dx equals dy over du multiplied by du over dx. The chain rule is used to find the derivative of a composite function. It tells us how to differentiate composite functions. And composite functions are a function within a function or a function of a function. So let's look at some examples. First, we're going to keep the chain rule in sight. Dy over dx equals dy du by du dx. Our first example, we're going to differentiate where y equals cos 3 of x, and this can also be written as cos x cubed. First, we state that u is equal to cos x, so y is equal to u cubed. Now, we differentiate each of those. Du dx is minus sine x, and dy du is 3u. So that's just applying the standard differentiation rules of cos x and u cubed. Here we're putting that information into our formula. So dy dx equals dy du, which is 3u, multiplied by du dx, which is minus sine x. Now we multiply that out, giving us dy dx equal to minus 3 cos x. Here we have replaced the u with what we had stated it was originally, cos x. So minus 3 cos x sine x. A second example will be looked at here. Again, we're going to keep our formula, dy dx equals dy du multiplied by du dx. This time, we're going to differentiate y equal to 4x minus 5 to the power of 8. Again, we follow the same steps. U is equal to 4x minus 5, so y equals u to the power of 8. Here we're differentiating each step. U becomes du dx is 4, and y becoming dy du is 8u to the power of 7. Now we put that information into our formula. Dy dx equals dy du, which is 8u to the power of 7, multiplied by du dx, which is 4. Here we're multiplying this out, and again, removing the u and putting in what it was standing for, which is 4x minus 5. So 32 by 4x minus 5 to the power of 7. Thank you.